Please, do you have any water? I'm so thirsty. You... are you serious? I can't offer anything in exchange, you know. I can just have it. I can just have it. For free? Really? Seriously? Oh my God. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'll never forget this.
Welcome to Megaton. Friendliest town around.
Those monsters, they're gonna get me. Those things, they keep coming. They scare me. Make it stop. You look stronger than all the other grown-ups. Can you protect me? Those big things. They're all over Great Itch, and they killed everyone. Please, mister, please find my papa. It used to be kinda nice. No one bothered us there. I guess because we were so close to DC. There were 7 of us living there in tall, old brick houses. I think I'm the last one left. Those things took everyone else. Nah. People don't like to stay long in Great Itch. The DC ruins aren't a great place to make a home, you know. In fact, Papa was talking about moving on soon. We've been here for maybe a year. Besides me and my Papa, there was Doc Lesko, who stayed with us, and Will Brandis, and his Mama and Papa, too. I guess they're all gone now. All right. What is it? Nah, go ahead. It's just nice to talk to anyone about stuff at all. He was a strange man. He paid Papa some caps to help him build a shack and carry a bunch of junk into it. Papa called him an egghead, but his head was shaped regular, so I didn't get it. He spent all of his time in that shack next door to my house. Every time I'd sneak in there, he'd be sitting at that funny-looking TV machine with the green words pushing buttons. Nah, he was a nice man, but he never wanted to play with me very much, and we barely talked. All I know is he was all gone when the ants started showing up. I think they got him too. I don't know. All kinds of doohickeys. Boxes with lots of lights, some funny glass bottles. Oh wait, he had a big, clunky, shiny man too. That was kind of neat. Yeah? Well, there is Will. He was sort of my friend. And then there was his dad and his mom. Right across the street, actually. It was pretty swell having someone to hang out with so close by. Yeah, Will was super nice to me. He was like a year older than me, I think. He even shared his comic books with me. We explored pretty much every bit of Great Itch we could find. I think that's why the ants don't bother me. I have good hiding spots. Well, his mom was nice too. She was kind of quiet, but she always took care of me and my papa when we came over. I think she was sad that my mom was gone. Will's dad was, well, I don't want to be mean, but he was kind of scary. He was like always watching me and my dad real careful, like he didn't trust us or something. He always kept staring at us from the windows of his house and typing stuff into his TV box. Will said his dad was like an old soldier or something, but he didn't like doing that stuff, so he quit. Yeah? All right. What is it? Well, they're big, ugly things that crawl around on six legs. They got huge teeth and skitter around grabbing everything in their path. My papa would always say they're fucking ants. Well, that's what he used to call them anyway. I just call them fire ants. Nah, those things started coming around only in the last few months. At first, they just crawled around outside our town. But later, they came into town and, well, you know the rest. My papa had a gun. He said it hurt those things, but he said they were the dumbest fucking ants he ever saw. He kept telling everyone to shoot for their antenna, whatever that means. All right. Look for the house nearest to the billboard. That's sticking out of the ground. It's pretty close to the diner. You can't miss it. You will? Really? Thanks a whole lot. My house is the one closest to the huge sign and the old diner. Please, find my papa and make him come back. Well, there is the personal shelter next to the old diner. Papa always said to stay away from it, but I guess it's supposed to be safe. I'll head over there and wait inside. Hurry back.
Hello. What do you need? Okay.
Hey.
Oh, I can't wait to hear how the repellent's working. Oh, excellent! Substantial field testing, precise reports, and such dedication. What more could I ask for in a research assistant? So, how did my chemical repellent work? Safe and clean like a charm, I'll bet. A shame. Poor little mole ratties. With that much testing, I guess it's beyond correction. Go ahead and keep it. Maybe you can find a nicer use for it, right? Oh, but for your trouble, here, have the leftover chems from working on the repellent. I'm sure you can find some use for them. There's a lot we don't know about Mirelurks and how intelligent and dangerous they are. That definitely deserves research. I hesitate to ask, but I'll need to examine the effects of serious physical trauma. I wouldn't ask if I couldn't fix you up afterwards, of course. And that should be it for the second chapter. Which do you want to check out? Well, I never get to study anyone who's severely injured. Not without them crying to be fixed right away or trying to bleed out and all that. But obviously, you can handle a lot of abuse. So if I'm ever going to find a good example of human anatomy and injury resistance, it'd be you. Next time you get badly injured, return here so I can examine you before I heal you up. I mean, you're going to get yourself hurt anyway, right? Wow, what a great research assistant you are. I mean, really, that's dedication. Demonstrating how to withstand pain by getting injured? Wow. When you're ready, come back here with some serious injuries. Maybe a crippled limb or two. And I'll take notes and fix you up. I'll be waiting here with plenty of bandages for you. So don't worry. Just go get horribly injured. Oh, and be careful. Well, how do you... Well, besides... Oh, hey! Good hunting!